What is going on YouTube, it's your boy Billy Kibaki, and in today's video I'll be showing off the one and only working Xbox 360 emulator. So I found this emulator on the internet, guys, and I must say that it's working pretty well with some games, but some other games it doesn't work that well. To my knowledge, this is the only working Xbox 360 I believe is out there. Okay, so I'll leave the link in the description if anybody wants to try it out for themselves. So let's go ahead and get started. So this is the website that I found the emulator on, guys. It's called xenia. Not sure if I'm pronouncing that properly, but on the right hand side right here we have a bunch of tabs that we can check out, like frequently asked question, download, compatibility gallery, and they have like a YouTube channel and stuff. But the one that you should check out first is the compatibility, and this right here you can type the name of the game you want to search for if it's working or not, or you can just use the top one that says compatibility tracker. If you click it, it's going to take you over to GitHub and you can just scroll down and see if a game is playable or not playable. Okay, so, and as I said, you can type the name of the game right here and wait for it to actually load up. So that's it, I just typed the name but it's taking a very long time to actually load. So you can choose whether to type the name or use the compatibility tracker, and they also have a Discord where you can talk to whoever on their Discord with. Okay, so after you've done that, you can click on download and you can download the Xbox emulator right here. That's it. Once you download it, locate it on your computer and then go ahead and extract it with WinRAR or 7-zip. Once you extract it, you're gonna get these three files right here. You wanna just double tap on the exe. So once you have this pop up, there's not much you can actually do. You can set it to full screen, trace frame, clear cache, and all of these other stuff. There isn't anything to like change the settings for it to work better on your computer. There isn't anything like that, but when you want to run your game, all you have to do is make sure that your Xbox game is in ISO format. That's the only way it will work. So just go ahead and click file, then open, and you're gonna search for your game. I'm gonna use Dragon Ball Z, Battle of Z. So just click it and press open. Also make sure that you have your Xbox controller connected to your computer. So let me just exit that, and as you can see, guys, the game start up pretty well. I'm just gonna start it up and let you see how it works.
Everyone on Earth, please share your energy with all the warriors of the world!
And as you can see, guys, it's not really 100% working properly. We have like half of the screen showing. And you can see I am moving it around. This is actually the emulator playing right now. So I'm just gonna press start and let you see the actual gameplay. And as you can tell, guys, it's not looking pretty from right here. Half of the screen shows a little bit better and the other half shows like this bright, bright color, you know. So as I said, you should definitely check the compatibility section first before going ahead and trying I'm playing the game straight off the bat like that. So I'm just gonna try and move around.
It feels like it's coming from around here. It's faint. Still doesn't feel very good. Well, I might as well get some training in while I search the area.
But I can't tell exactly what am I doing because everything just seems like I'm seeing through like walls and stuff. But yeah, I can definitely do stuff. Just that one side of the street.
Okay, going great. I'm probably going to be scolded by Chi-Chi again for training so much and not working.
Okay,
I think I'll scope the area from the sky using my flight technique.
And if you find one that you want to play, just go ahead and give it a try. So guys, that's it. If this video was helpful, please leave a like. Also share the video. And you can also subscribe for more videos. So thanks for watching and I'll see you in my next video.